Hi everyone, Ramesh here. In this video, I want to show you how to develop simple Spring MUC web application with Thymeleap. We are going to use Spring Boot to quickly create and bootstrap our Spring MUC web application. So Spring Boot is an extension of Spring Framework, and we can use Spring Boot to quickly create and bootstrap our Spring-based applications. Alright, and we are going to use Thymeleap to create HTML pages. That is, we are going to use Thymeleap to create a view layer in a Spring MUC web application. This is a very simple web application, and this application shows how to integrate Thymeleap in Spring Boot application. Okay, so let's have a look into the tools and technology that we are going to use. So I am going to use Eclipse STS IDE, but you can also use IntelliJ. We are going to use Spring Boot 2.2.6 release. So this is the latest release of Spring Boot as of now, and Spring Boot 2 Plus internally uses Spring Framework 5 Plus, and we are going to use Maven 3.2, and then we use JDK 1.8. So however, you can use JDK 9, 10, 11 as per your requirement. But make sure that you have to use JDK 1.8 or later, okay? And we are going to use Embedded Tomcat Server 8.5 plus. So Spring Boot out of the box provides a default Embedded Tomcat Server which has a version 8.5 plus, okay? And we are going to use Thymeleap 3.0. So this is the latest release of Thymeleap as of now. So these are the tools and technologies that we will be using in this tutorial. As usual, I am going to create this tutorial step by step, and here are the steps. So first we create a Spring Boot project, and then we add all the required dependencies, and then we create a simple Spring MUC controller which will handle HTTP request, and then we will see the Thymeleap view resolver configuration. So whenever Spring Boot finds a Thymeleap dependency in a class path, then Spring Boot will automatically configure a view resolver for Thymeleap, and it will point the default location of Thymeleap templates. So we need to make explicitly add Thymeleap templates path. So this we'll see in a example. Next, we create a Thymeleap template page to display a data on a browser. And next, we'll finally run the application and we'll see the demo. So these are the steps we are going to implement. Alright, without further ado, let's go ahead and let's create a Spring Boot project from the scratch. Alright, let's get started. I am in Eclipse STS IDE. Let's go ahead and let's create a Spring Boot project. Go to the file, new, and then choose Spring Starter Project. So this is a Spring Initializer website which is integrated in our Eclipse STS IDE. So we can use Spring Initializer to quickly create and bootstrap our Spring-based applications. So let's go ahead and let's configure our project details over here. So let's give a name to the project: Spring Boot Thymeleap example. I'm going to give hello world example. Okay. So this is a very simple hello world example. So let me give a name like this, and group ID, you can give any group ID that you want, but I'm going to give net.javaguides because my website name is javaguides.net. So I prefer to give a group ID as like this, and keep Maven as it is because we are going to use a Maven project, and packaging as a jar, and language Java, and Java version 8. However, you can choose 11, 14 as per your requirement. And then artifact ID is our application name, and this is the description: demo project for Spring Boot and Thymeleap. Okay, and package as net.javaguides.springboot. Alright, so once you are happy with the details, click next, and look at here, this is Spring Boot version. So this is the latest release and stable release, so let's keep as it is. And here we need to choose Spring Web Starter dependency. So this dependency provides Spring MUC, related libraries internally. So we are going to use Spring Web Starter dependency to create our Spring MVC web application. And we can also create a RESTful web services by using Spring Web Starter dependency. And Spring Web Starter dependency internally provides embedded Tomcat server as a servlet container. Alright. And we are going to use Thymeleap template engine as a view layer. So let's go ahead and let's choose Thymeleap here. Alright, so these are the two dependencies are enough to create our simple Spring MVC web application with Thymeleap. Alright, once we are happy with the details, then hit finish. So this will create a Spring Boot project in Eclipse STS IDE. Okay, so this is the first step. Now let us see the next step. Next step is we need to add Maven dependencies. Let's open the pom.xml and let's confirm whether all the dependencies are present in pom.xml or not. So look at here, we need a Spring MVC libraries. So for that, we have added Spring Boot Starter Web dependency, and we are going to use Thymeleap as a view layer. So we have also added Thymeleap Spring Boot Starter dependency. Alright, we are good with all the dependencies that are there in a pom.xml. Now let us see the next step is creating Spring MVC controller. So let's go ahead and let's create a simple Spring MVC controller. So what I will do, I will create a package first, and let's give a name as controller. Alright, and right click new and create a class, and let's call it as Hello Controller. Okay, and look at here, this is the main entry point of our Spring Boot project, and it has annotated with @ Spring Boot application annotation. So this annotation internally has the combination of three annotations, that is @ component scan, @ enable auto configuration, and @ configuration. Okay, so this annotation will handle all the default configurations internally. We no need to manually add the bins and default configurations, etc. Okay, so look at here, this annotation is a convenient annotation, and it is equivalent to these three annotations. Okay, great. Now this is our Spring MVC controller. Let's annotate this class with @ controller annotation. So this annotation will identify that this class is a Spring MVC controller, and it will handle all the HTTP requests that has a particular URL. Let me create a method handler, and then I will explain you. Public string, and let's call it as a hello. Let's keep very simple. So we are just learning how we can, you know, use Thymeleap in Spring Boot project with a hello world example. Okay, and here we are going to use get mapping annotation. Okay, and what I will do here is we'll assign two URLs here. This is the URL for home, and this is the URL for hello. Okay, so we can access this method by using these two URLs. Okay, good, great. Now we can also use query parameter here. So we can use a query parameter to dynamically update the values. For example, I'm going to use @ request param annotation to bind a query parameter directly to the method argument. All right and here is a value. So value equals name, and we have default value. So default value, let's give as world, and then required, so it's a required, so let's give as a true, and let's bind this value to the name here. It's pretty simple. And let's create a one more argument here, model. So we need to supply some data to the view layer. For that we need to create a model here. Okay, so this is our method arguments. Now what we'll do, we'll simply return a view name here. So I'm going to call hello. So So we'll create a hello timelib template in a next section. So here what we'll do, we'll add key value pair to the model. So let's add our data to the model here. So let's say key as name and value as name. Okay, it's pretty simple. So look at here, this is the method handler, and whenever a request come with a slash or a hello, then this method of a handler will handle this HTTP request. And this is the query parameter. So we are using at the rate request parameterization to bind a query parameter value to the name, that is the string. And here is the model. So we are going to supply some data to the view layer. So for that we are going to use a model, and whatever a query parameter we pass, that will we pass to the model, and then model will pass again to the template. All right, this is the third step. Let us see the next step. Next step is we will see timelib view resolver configuration. So basically we no need to add a view resolver for timelib, because Spring Boot automatically configures a view resolver whenever it will find a timelib, you know, timelib dependency in a class path. However, you can specify the location of the timelib template engines in a application.properties file, but by default Spring Boot will pick up all the timelib templates from this location, that is template location. Okay, here inside this folder we create a timelib templates. Let us see the next step. So next step is we create a simple timelib template page. So in a templates folder, right click on this folder, new, and go to the others, search for HTML here, and let's give a template name as hello.html. okay, and let's add a timelib expression to display a name here. All right, so this is the expression which render a value of the name on a web page. This name value comes from the controller from the here. Okay, it's pretty simple timelib web page which will just render a name value to the web page. Okay, it's pretty simple. Next step is we run the application and we'll see the demo. All right, now let's go ahead and let's run the Spring Boot project. So this is our entry point of our Spring Boot project. So let's right click on this project, run as Spring Boot app. So this will run our Spring Boot application in a default embedded Tomcat server. So look at here, our Spring Boot application is up and running on embedded Tomcat server port 8080. Now let's access our application from the browser. Open the Chrome browser and just type a localhost 8080. So look at here, hello world. Okay, we got a success response from the server. So this is basically a hello.html page which rendered here on our browser. Now we can also pass a query parameters here, like name admin. Here you can see the name is dynamically changing here, hello admin. If I change name from admin to Ramesh, so this will say hello Ramesh. Alright, so this is a very simple Spring MVC application with timelib using Spring Boot. Okay, so pretty simple. So this is the timelib expression which render value of the name on a browser. Alright, so you can also extend this timelib Spring Boot hello world application by creating a real world entities, and you can use a database to store the data. Alright, I have already created Spring Boot timelib root examples where I have shown you how to create a entity, how to update, delete and list out the entities. So you can just search Spring Boot timelib root example in my YouTube channel, you will find it. Okay, I hope you understood how to create a simple Spring Boot EMUC web application with timelib step by step. So you can just follow these steps, you will be able to successfully complete this tutorial. Okay, great. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. Whenever I will publish such videos, you will get notified. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.